Welcome to everyone's favorite reality TV show, Who's Telling the Truth? Today we have Hansel and Gretel in the studio with us. You all remember Hansel and Gretel. They are the kids who were lost in the forest for 3 days. They are here with their father and stepmother to tell their story.
Yeah, hooray! Yay for us!
Also with us today is the witch.
Excuse me, but I'm not a witch. Do I really look like a witch to you?
Well, no.
Sure, she's all cleaned up, looking nice and pretty now. But you should have seen her in the forest when we ran into her.
And you should see her house. It's full of all sorts of strange fruits and evil concoctions.
Lies. All of it.
Yes, well, that's why we're here today. We're going to find out what happened that fateful day. When Hansel and Gretel came upon Esmeralda in the forest, it's up to you, our studio audience, to tell who's telling the truth.
We are!
We'll see about that, kids. Whoever our studio audience sides with will walk out of here with $10,000. Now, if you will all take your places, we can get started.
We get to go first!
Yeah, we won the coin toss backstage, remember?
Yes, I remember. Go ahead and tell our studio audience what happened.
Well, we were in the woods
working our merit badges for the nature conservation.
Merit badges? When did you kids join the scouts?
A while ago. Anyway, we came upon this strange house made of candy and gingerbread.
You could tell us the whole purpose was to lure innocent, unsuspecting children like us to it.
What? Ridiculous!
You'll have an opportunity to tell your side of the story after Hansel and Gretel finish their side, Esmeralda. Now go on, kids. Tell us what happened when you arrived at the gingerbread house.
We were just standing there admiring the pretty house. All of a sudden, that scary witch over there came out on the porch.
She had a black robe and pointy black hat. And when she smiled, she was missing a bunch of teeth.
Preposterous. I don't have a black robe or hat. I assure you that I'm not missing any teeth. Look at my smile.
Daddy, make her stop interrupting us.
Excuse me, Tina. I thought that each side gets to tell a version of events without interruption.
Yes, that is the rule, Esmeralda. I'll have to ask you again to please let the children finish their story.
I'm sorry. I just want to make sure the audience knows that these children are lying.
We're not lying! We never lie!
Yeah, she probably went to the dentist and got her teeth fixed.
Okay, please don't argue, Esmeralda. I need you to stop interrupting the kids. Go ahead and finish your story. What happened when Esmeralda came out of her house?
She asked us what we were doing. I told her we were looking for wildflowers.
I thought you said you were working on your merit badges.
We were looking for wildflowers for our merit badges.
This really isn't the important part of the story. Mindy, kids, just tell everyone what happened when you ran into the witch. Esmeralda.
She invited us in her house for some gingerbread and milk, but she's a stranger, and we're not supposed to talk to strangers or accept treats from them.
Plus, we didn't want to spoil our dinner. Our stepmother makes the most delicious meatloaf in the whole wide world. So we said no thank you, and we started to walk away.
But she wouldn't let us leave. She grabbed us and she said she was going to turn us into gingerbread children and eat us up.
She's really obsessed with gingerbread.
We tried to get away, but she caught us. Then she dragged us inside her house and locked us in a cave.
Oh, my poor children.
There, dear.
She kept us prisoner for 3 days, and the only thing she gave us to eat was candy.
She gave us candy because she wanted to fatten us up. Then, when we were fat enough, she threw us into her oven. But I kicked the oven door open. We managed to escape.
Excuse me, Gretel. Please don't play with those wires.
I'm not.
It kind of looked like you were.
I wasn't.
Tina, it may have looked like Gretel was playing with those wires, but if she said she wasn't, she wasn't. My children are very well behaved, and they hardly do anything wrong.
Sorry, I had something caught in my throat.
Let's move on. Esmeralda, would you like to tell your version of what happened that day? Yes, I would. There are so many intricacies in the story Hansel and Gretel told you that I hardly know where to begin.
Are you saying you did threaten to turn my beautiful children into gingerbread children? Are you saying you didn't lock them in your oven?
I didn't do any of the story.
Then explain why my poor children are missing for 3 days and why they arrived battered, bruised, and covered in soup.
Because they were playing in an old abandoned cottage about a mile from my house. And that's where they got battered, bruised, and covered with soup. And when I took them into my house, they refused to take baths.
That's not true, Daddy.
Yeah, I don't know what she's talking about. We never saw any red brick cottage with a really cool crumbly chimney. Ow, why you punch me, Gretel?
And we definitely would have taken that if she let us. You know how we hate to be dirty. Sorry, I seem to have something caught in my throat.
Not only did they see the cottage, they were both running around like hooligans inside it. I heard them when I was out gathering wild herbs. I peeked in the window and saw them climbing up the old stone fireplace inside.
That couldn't be possible. That couldn't possibly be true.
It is, sir, and I was worried about them, so I went inside and told them to climb up. They just laughed at me and climbed higher. Then the boy Hansel lost his footing and fell.
Oh my goodness, those kids are always climbing up on things at home. I keep telling them that one day they're going to fall and get hurt.
I picked the pencil and carried them back to my house so I could tend his wounds. The kids told me they didn't have any family and they didn't have a place to live.
What?
They said that was why they were in the rented cottage. They planned to live there.
What did they tell you about their family?
It doesn't matter, dear. None of this is true.
The children told me that their father had married a horrible woman who took them into the woods and told them to never come back. They said their evil stepmother told them they weren't wanted anymore.
What horrible children to make up such a story?
Watch what you say about my darling children, baby.
I told them they were welcome to stay with me. I have a spare room and I thought perhaps they could help me with my work.
What kind of work do you do?
I'm a gingerbreadologist.
A what?
A gingerbreadologist. I study gingerbread. It's one of the most useful substance known. It can be used as food, of course, but also as medicine and as a building material.
Your house is really made out of gingerbread?
That's one thing the children got right. It's probably the only thing they got right.
What were the children doing in your home for 3 days?
Mostly getting into trouble. I never seen such out of control children. They climbed my counters, overturned furniture, and threw my cookie sheets around. I asked them to calm down, and they laughed. But the worst thing was when they started leaving my house. So then I told them they had to leave. I felt bad that they had no place to go, but I couldn't have them in my house for any longer. I simply couldn't tolerate it.
I hate to tell you this, darling, but what Esmeralda is saying does sound so bad to me.
What?
Listen, I love Hansel and Gretel as if they were my own children, but there's something you need to know about them.
What's that?
They're a little undisciplined.
They're free spirits.
No, dear, I've been afraid to tell you this for fear it would upset you, but your children are careless, loud, and undisciplined. They do what they want and they want when they want, and then they lie about it later.
Don't listen to her, Daddy. She hates us.
She's trying to turn you against us, your own flesh and blood. I would never do that, Charles. I'm afraid you've got a blind spot when it comes to your children and their faults.
Why does everybody keep saying things like that? Hansel and Gretel are good children.
Yes, but good children need discipline. Good children need to be taught right from wrong. What these children did when they were with Esmeralda was wrong, and they continued to do wrong when they came home and told lies about what happened to them.
Do you really think they're lying?
Why don't we ask our studio audience folks? If you think Hansel and Gretel are telling the truth, applaud now. Okay, if you think Esmeralda is telling the truth, applaud now. Well, it's pretty clear that our studio thinks Esmeralda is telling the truth. So that means Esmeralda walks away with $10,000!
I don't care about the money as much as I care about the truth. And that's the whole reason I came on this show, for the opportunity to tell my side of the story and hope that the people would believe me.
We believe you, Esmeralda.
Maybe you're right, Mindy. Maybe I am lying to my children's folks.
What?
You can't mean it, Daddy.
I'm terribly sorry for everything my children have put you through, Esmeralda.
You believe her over us?
We do. Thank you. That's all I really wanted.
Things are going to change around our house. I'll be watching you, and when I see you misbehave, there will be consequences.
And that wraps another episode of Who's Telling the Truth? Now stay tuned for the Daily Life Show. Today's topic is parents who ground their kids and kids who don't stay grounded. Hansel, Gretel, Charles, and Mindy. Maybe you should stick around for that show too.
The end.